for a $50 donation. Really anyone can send in the name of one of their exes. And what we'll do is we'll name a community cat after that person, first names or nicknames only. And then that community cat will be spayed or neutered, vaccinated, ear tipped, and then released back out to the community. We keep any cats that are feral and really don't want to socialize or interact with humans. We try to keep them in a really quiet area to reduce stress before they go back out to the community. So just around the corner here is kind of the area where we try to concentrate just the most feral cats. So it's right back here, these guys. So you can see definitely back in this area, we have a lot of the cats that are towards the back of their cages, very, very, you know, stressed and tense in the shelter environment. Sounds good. All right, so we have three cats that are recovering from anesthesia. So they would have been spayed and neutered already. And right now they're getting their finishing touches and TLC. So we're keeping them warm and keeping them stimulated, cleaning out their ears, and you know, just taking good care of them as they're recovering. The response from our community, near and far, has really been overwhelming, and it's been really, you know, kind of funny to see what people have been sending in. It looks like so far the most common names sent in are Jeff, Mike, Ian, and Tyler. So those are the four most common ex names sent in. I think my favorite is Gaslight Guy. that was a nickname for one of the cats. So I think people are having fun with it. And again, it's a $50 donation that results in the spay and neuter of one of the community cats here in Camden County. And so it's making a tremendous difference. So this is our cat drop-off area. During our peak season, this every single cage would be filled in this area. A lot of these are going to be new cats that just came in recently. Oh, it's a huge problem. Actually, across the United States, really all over the world, overpopulation of community cats is a huge issue. So really we need to work all together to take care of those cats and ultimately spaying and neutering those cats to control overpopulation so that we don't just have more kittens, you know, year after year. You know, one female adult cat in just one breeding season could have 2 to 3 litters. In each litter, there could be 4 to 6 kittens, and then each one of those kittens, once they reach reproductive age, they're going to start breeding, and you know, it just really compounds the problem. And you know, when there's not enough homes for all of these cats in our community, you know, we really just need to take the initiative, work together, and spay and neuter these cats. Here in our shelter last year, we trapped, neutered, and returned over 600 cats. But coming into our shelter, the problem is much greater. We can take in well over 3,000 cats each year. And we know that shelters all over the nation, all over you know, the world, are struggling with very similar problems. Feral cats, they are, or you know, I refer to them a lot as community cats. They're very crafty, and they, you know, they've lived alongside humans for pretty much forever, and they find little niches, and in the community they can find food to eat, and they're really thriving, but there's always a limit towards how many you can have in the community. They're always going to be there. We're not going to, you know, they'll always be living alongside of us. But again, if we can spay and neuter those cats so that there's less of them, a spayed and neutered cat is going to be less likely to develop signs of disease. They're not going to be roaming and moving around. So just by the act of spaying and neutering that animal, vaccinating them for some of the most important diseases, we're setting them up for success for the rest of their lives. This part of the facility is open 24/7 to animal control. So being open admission means that we accept every animal in need that comes to us. So we'll have really all day long through the night animal control officers dropping off new cats and kittens. Some days during our peak season, this whole entire cage bank, we can come in and the whole thing will be full. This campaign is clever, it's funny, but it's also going to just make an incredible difference, because we're going to have this fund that we can use to spay and neuter community cats, and it's just one example of us all working together to solve these problems.